Hi, my name is Gabrielle Calvocoressi. We're reading For 3 Days by my great teacher, Marie Howe, who taught me a great deal about how to be human, both in poems and outside of them. For 3 days now, I've been trying to think of another word for gratitude, because my brother could have died and didn't. Because for a week, we stood in the intensive care unit trying not to imagine how it would be then, afterwards. My youngest brother, Andy, said, "This is so weird. I don't know if I'll be talking with John today or buying a pair of pants for his funeral." And I hated him for saying it because it was true and seemed to tilt it, because I had been writing his elegy in my head during the 7-hour drive there and trying not to. Thinking meant not thinking. It meant imagining my brother surrounded by light, like Schrödinger's cat, that would be dead if you looked and might live if you didn't. And then it got better. And then it got worse. And it's a story now. He came back. And I did, by that time, imagine him dead. And I did begin to write the other story, how the crowd in the stifling church snapped to a tearful attention. How my brother lived again for a few minutes through me. And although I know I couldn't help it, because fear has its own language and its own story, because even grief provides a living remedy, I can't help but think of that woman who said to him whom she considered her savior, "If thou hadst been here, my brother had not died," how she might have practiced her speech, and how she too might have stood trembling, unable to meet the eyes of the dear familiar figure that stumbled from the cave when the compassionate fist of God opened and crushed her with gratitude and shame.